we thank God for you and we welcome you to this edition of the Voice of Resurrection devotional. I'm excited because I'm teaching things that will cause you to experience a greater level in God, a higher realm in the Spirit. Because the more aligned you are with the Lord, the more things work the way they are supposed to. And in the days to come, as we study, it will become even clearer. Hallelujah. So we are finishing our study on Romans 14, verse 17 through 18. For the kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. For he that in these things serveth Christ is acceptable to God and approved of men. We've looked at the righteousness part in serving Christ. And then we've talked briefly about the peace that comes out of that righteousness and how it is the governing force and the umpire that rules and helps us stay on track. Most new luxury cars have these lane awareness and control. And I drove a car recently where if you don't put your blinker to change lanes, it will vibrate and let you know that you're drifting off course. It's just that's that kind of umpire. Like in a ball game, there's an infraction. The referee blows a whistle. And the reason that happens is because the Holy Spirit is trying to chaperone you into joy, which is the ultimate realization of the kingdom. The joy of the Lord being your strength. He says, even when you go forth in Psalm 126, I believe, even when you go forth weeping, bearing precious seed, he says, you shall doubtless come rejoicing with your own sheaves. It's a destination joy. That's the kingdom of God manifest. The kingdom of God coming forth. The kingdom of God being revealed in you. And it says that if you serve Christ Jesus, see, I keep saying it, that when there is no joy in your life, then you know something is wrong. You have deviated from serving the Lord. Because when you are serving Him correctly, then you will be rightly related. Then the peace of God will be functioning. Then you will reach this destination of the joy of the Lord. You must remember that joy is not happiness. You get a new job, you're happy. You get a new car, you're happy. You get a new house, you're happy. You get engaged, you're happy. You got married, you're happy. But joy is the testament that the will of God has been done. The joy is the testimony that God is pleased. Joy is the testimony that I am in the will of God. And he says, if I serve the Lord this way, then I am acceptable to God. I know the Bible says that we are accepted in the beloved. See, that's another one of those positioning scriptures. But when we submit to the righteousness of God and the peace of God emanates and the joy of the Lord is revealed, beloved, we functionally are accepted. We are in that place of pleasure where God blesses, God favors, God crowns us, God prospers us. That's what we want, beloved. He says, I am acceptable to God. Watch this. And I'm even approved of men. Wow. That means men are desperate to see a man with some joy. To see a man that's rightly related to God. Whenever there's a crisis, people begin to look for people they believe are in touch with God. So everybody knows the truth. Even the demons know the truth. That's why they keep trying to seduce you, the believer, to enter into sin so you will not be the favorite. You will not be the light in the midst of darkness. You will not be the one that will be in position to help people when Satan unleashes his fury. That's why he keeps tempting us to sin, so we can move away from our position of righteousness and steadfastness with God, where we'll become a pleasure unto the Lord, where the Lord will want to hang out with us, where the Lord will want to bless us and increase us and favor us. It's such a wonderful thing. Oh, beloved, he said, man will approve. Remember the scripture that says, if a man's ways please the Lord, he says, even his enemies, God will make his enemies to be at peace with him. Oh, it's such a wonderful thing. I pray for you that this study has opened your eyes in some measure, for you to understand your responsibility in serving the Lord in these dimensions, in the peace, the level of peace in your life, in the level of joy in your life, in how rightly related you are with the Lord. And you know, if you're related rightly with the Lord, it will manifest in your lateral relationship with your brothers and sisters. Don't join the fake crowd that claims to be rightly related to God and that at odds with everybody else. That's a fake. That's a pole. A cross is the right relationship with the Lord, and then the right relationship with people. The Bible says, as much as there's light in you, live peaceable with all men. In other words, you should give it your best shot. And another scripture says, as much as is possible. That says sometimes it's not, because when somebody is demonized, you can't have peace with them because there's no peace within. This is only possible in the framework of the children of God, the true sons of God, who are endeavoring to keep that bond of unity, that spirit of unity in the bond of peace. Those that are children of God, that are, love the Lord and are interested in the kingdom of God taking hold and ruling. Yes, they will approve of a man walking with the Lord in peace and righteously and in the joy of the Lord. That's my prayer for you. That's my wish for you this week. That's what we'll be pressing into in the weeks to come. That righteousness will prevail. Ah, it will impact society. It will change everything. May God make you that light in the midst of darkness and thrust you forth in this generation to represent him accurately. In Jesus' name, amen. We love you. We'll see you next week. Apostle, bye-bye.